Yes, boss. Back in here again, once again. 444 the world. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. Good morning. It's Friday. And you know, I'm back with another one. And today's topic, I'm going to switch it up, do it real different. You know what I'm saying? This is a topic I never did before, so I'm newly introducing it. You know what I'm saying? Understanding the devil. All right? Now, a lot of people hear the term devil or demon and don't really try to understand or break it down to see what that means to be a devil or understand the devil, because the world is tricked. Everything is backwards. A lot of people believe evil is good and good is evil. You get what I'm saying? So I'm going to break that down for you, all right? And there's a Bible verse that even tells you about it, right? The devil is like a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour. So be sober and be vigilant, right? Now, that right there just pretty much describes the devil on a whole. And if you can really think about that whole scripture I just gave you and just think about it. Seeking whom he may devour. Devour is eat. So a lion that's roaring is looking for his prey, right? So example, when you have friends, family, right? And they're supposed to be friends and family, which is supposed to be there for you, right? That means that they should be on your side. But sometimes that's not how the thing, how things always turn out to be. It's because a lot of people have ulterior motives and they have other things on the inside that make them do that, right? Now, pretty sure everybody's seen it in a commercial or on TV and cartoons where you see the angel and the devil, right? That's to represent the choices that you have, right? Like your conscience. So you can choose to hate somebody or you can choose to help them. You can choose to be a real friend or you can choose to be a piss poor friend. You get what I'm saying? But it's no in between, good, evil. So it's not hard to really understand the devil. So when they say the devil is like a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour, that means every and anybody. So to go deeper to help you understand where I'm going with this, to everybody who understands like the little early times in the Bible or little things that was said about, oh, the devil was in charge of music. He played beautiful music for God. He was God's top angel. The devil had looks. The devil had this. The devil had that, right? Now, what happened? You're not in heaven anymore, right? So I started to think about that. What caused him to get kicked out of heaven? Oh, he wanted there to be two gods, right? You're underneath the big God, but you want to be up here with him, right? So it's like, dog, if I made you and put you on and gave you all of this stuff, you control music, you play music for me, all of these things, you beautiful, you this, you perfect, what else do you want? Oh, all right, cool. Kicked out of heaven, right? And ever since then, he's been tricking, finessing, took angels with him. You get what I'm saying? So when you really hear that and you think about it, you were in heaven. Heaven is good. Everything was beautiful, right? You played yourself. You got kicked out. Now you're in hell. What does that sound like to you? Let me break it down for you. This guy and this girl, right? Two of them together. This girl has everything. Been holding it down, working hard her whole life, all of that, right? Then you got this dude who comes in and like, yeah, I want this, I want that. And you're abusing the power, the authority that you got. You get what I'm saying? You get kicked out of heaven. Now it's back to hell you go. Back to the people that don't care about you. Back to the people that are shyst you. Back to all of the things that's not good. Kicked out of heaven. Locked out of heaven. Bruno Mars made a song about that. You know what I'm saying? So really, when you try to think about it, the Bible is really like a riddle. It's like it's written in like allegory or something, where you have to really sit there and break down certain words and certain terminologies to get what it is that you want. I'm gonna give you another example. Adam and Eve, right? They said Eve was tricked by the serpent, right? So you think to yourself, dog, would a serpent trick a woman? A serpent is a symbolism for something. A snake. Who plays a snake? A person, right? Cool. Who can finesse a female and make her do whatever it is that she wants? A man. You know what I'm saying? So little things right there, it just gives you the answer to what it is that you're looking for. So when you really think about it, because the devil was kicked out of heaven, tried to abuse his power, tried to overstep his boundaries, cross the line, I need more power, all of that, you lost all your privileges. Time for you to go now. And ever since then, he's been tricking and finessing people. Because he got locked out of heaven, he wants you to lose your spot. I'm going to break that down another way. Listen to what I just said. So you got a friend, right? Your friend know that your dude is loyal, hardworking, all of these things, right? But then they go boost you to go do something that you know your boyfriend or your man or your spouse or whoever wouldn't like, right? That friend is playing the devil's advocate, right? Show you why. If you know and they know that that's something that would be a no-no to your spouse or something that's a no-no to God, let's just use him as an example. To God, which is, God, we're like little gods. You get what I'm saying? It's just an example, right? To that person, they're trying to get you out of your situation, locked out of heaven, casted into the world, which is hell. You get what I'm saying? That's just the way I look at it. So that person, really and truly, you got to think about it. That's not your friend. You get what I'm saying? Anybody that's giving you wrong information to see you crumble, fall, stumble, fail, not make it, not have a McDonald's cheese smile on your face, not none of that stuff, they're not your friend. I.e., they're playing the role of the devil. It's not that hard. Another thing, understanding the devil. When you really take a step back and you really think about it, right? If you lost your happiness, right? And you're living in misery and hell, that would make sense for you to be like, you know what? I can't hold my own. I did things the wrong way. Let me take other people down with me. Slow it down. I just dissed you. All right. What type of people do that? The people will be like, yo, I'm a badass. I'm a rebel. I'm a gangster. I'm a thug. Let me go do this. You couldn't hold your own weight. Now, what do? You bring other people down with you, like the devil. You get what I'm saying? If you know that in life, that there is a balance, as I say, forward, backward, night, day, good, evil, try your best to use discernment to get yourself out of a situation or prevent yourself from getting into a situation. You get what I'm saying? Life is a game of chess. In chess, you cannot be jumping back and forth. Oh, let me take my move back in. Nah. Once you make your move, it's final. And in chess, in order to win, you have to make your next move your best move. You can't be out here being lackadaisical, doing goofy stuff, loafing, just playing around every day like every day is a joke. People are out here looking to destroy you. You get what I'm saying? There are people who will see, yo, this person got everything that I want, right? That's the devil. That entitlement, and that's another video that's gonna come, that feeling like, oh, I should have what they have. I put in work too. But you don't know where that person has been. You don't know what that person has done. but you want to destroy and you want to take from them, i.e. be the devil. You get what I'm saying? There's people who believe that that mindset of being shysty and doing whatever it is that they want to get whatever it is that they need is the proper way to do things. And that's not right. You cannot expect in life to get straight W's all day long when you've been out here dealing a messed up hand. You get served what you deserve. Karma. So whether it's good that you've been putting out or it's bad that you've been putting out, you're going to get it back in that same form. You know what I'm saying? So with that being said, in this age that we're living in is the age of revelation, or some people say age of Aquarius. Age of Aquarius meaning a lot of knowledge, a lot of information is out here. We're in the internet ages. You can look up stuff. You get what I'm saying? You could go to the library and do whatever it is that you need. But understand this, in life, it doesn't pay to be a messed up person, do messed up things to other people, and then feel like you're of God or you're a good person. No, God doesn't tell you, hey, go and destroy that person so you can stay in the lead. No, that's not God. That's of the devil. And remember this. You're not a loser. I say that in every video. The people who do shiesty stuff, you're not a loser. You just need to change your ways. The people that's been doing good out here and you've been overlooked, trust me, I know what it feels like, but we always know the rules. The underdogs always win. The last shall be first and the first shall be last. So whenever you feel like, yo, you ain't been making it in life, certain things ain't been going for you, I know what that feels like. It sucks, but it's because you're not able to see the hard work that you've been putting out. You're not able to see the rewards for what it is that you've been doing. Just have faith and trust that, you know, it's all gonna come. It's just in timing. And the people that try to shortstop you, try to put a roadblock in the road for you to stop you, i.e. play the devil's role, they're gonna get what's coming to them. You get what I'm saying? There shall be no rest for the wicked. You get what I'm saying? So people who do a lot of messed up stuff and think it's not gonna come back to them, they're already living in hell up here. And it's going to start to come to them more in a physical way where they start to see the rewards of all the evil stuff they've done to people. You get what I'm saying? So with that being said, you guys put a smile on your face. It's Friday. You get what I'm saying? About to go into work. Knock out today and then that's just it. With that being said, it's 4:44 the world. Like, comment, subscribe. Love you guys. Enjoy the day. Enjoy the weekend. Put a smile on your face. Probably might go get margaritas later. Who knows? But it's Friday. You guys enjoy your day. Don't work too hard. Peace.